investor, CEO, and product architect of Tesla, Elon Musk, said, and I quote, "Tesla cells should be called nickel graphite, because firstly, the cathode is nickel, and the anode side is graphite with silicon dioxide. Hey, pencils are made of lead, right? No, they never were. Ancient Romans used to use stylus, and those were made out of lead. But ever since the modern pencil was invented by Nicolas Jacques Conté in 1795, pencils have used graphite. Pencil leads are not made of metal lead, that causes lead poisoning. So, what graphite has to do with Teslas? Graphite is native mineral found in metamorphic and igneous rocks. It is solid, dark, soft, and has a greasy feel, and leaves a black mark. It got its name in 1789 from the word graphene, which means to write. Here are the main uses of graphite. Graphite is mainly used in pencils, lubricants, crucibles, foundry facings, polishes, arc lamps, batteries, brushes for electric motors, and cores of nuclear reactors. It consists of 6 carbon atoms, arranged in widely spaced horizontal sheets, and linked to form a ring that has covalent bonds, and can slide easily over adjacent rings, which makes graphite good for writing and in lithium-ion batteries. You may be wondering, lithium-ion batteries? Yep, lithium-ion batteries like the ones found in all of our electronic devices, like your smartphone and tablet, and even electric vehicles like Tesla, contain graphite, a lot of it in fact. If you are thinking that lithium-ion battery is full of lithium, let me tell you that in a typical lithium-ion battery, lithium just makes up about 2%. It is not a surprising fact that once the investor, CEO, and product architect of Tesla, Elon Musk, said, and I quote, "Tesla cells should be called nickel graphite, because firstly, the cathode is nickel, and the anode side is graphite with silicon dioxide. There's a little bit of lithium in there, but it's like the salt on the salad." The Tesla company's name is a tribute to inventor and electrical engineer, Nikola Tesla. According to Elon Musk, the purpose of Tesla is to help expedite the move to sustainable transport and energy obtained through electric vehicles and solar power. Currently, about 2/3 of the world's graphite comes from China, which is great for Chinese battery companies. There's some graphite mines in India, Brazil, and Australia. The New Vermont Graphite Company, located in Canada, is one of the only mines in the world that aims to be carbon neutral and powered by electricity, not fossil fuels involved here. This is good because fossil fuels are known to cause not only respiratory problems, but also brain damages in infants. For example, they release carbon monoxide that, when react with hemoglobin in blood, they prevent it from carrying oxygen to our blood. They also release sulfur dioxide that causes respiratory diseases and acid rain. They release lead compounds, which damage the kidney and nervous system in adults. For these reasons, electric vehicles are a good way to go. If you are driving one, count yourself on the list of coolest people around. It is a fact that there's going to be an explosion of companies and factories to build millions of electric vehicles. Researchers are constantly working with battery chemistry to find denser, lighter, and cheaper mixtures. For more about graphite, watch this video on what happens if you eat graphite. The link is provided in the description and in the comment section. So, did you know that the anode side of Tesla's cell is graphite? Let me know down in the comment. If you learned something new today, give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos every week. Take care, and stay safe.